टू वन एंड ऑल, वेलकम टू ब्रह्म मुंबई जी नॉट वार्ड, माई सेल्फ भक्ति सुधीर खरात, धारावी काला किल्ला, ब्रह्म मुंबई महानगर पालिका, शिक्षण विभाग जी उत्तर, माई सेल्फ मिसेस भक्ति सुधीर खरात, एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर मिसेस स्नेहलता डुमदे, नोडल बीट ऑफिसर मिस्टर शरद पुराडे, नोडल एच एम मिसेस मेरी पुष्पम पॉल, असिस्टेंट नोडल एच एम मिसेस मनप्रीत कौर आनंद, CNO Mr. Ratilal Kishan Burungale. Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe. We start with our day with a small prayer. Students, say after me now. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
For giving us.
Nice day.
Given wisdom to learn new things. Yes, we are thankful to God to give us this nice day, give us wisdom to learn the new things. Children, now today's thought for the day: education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world, by APJ Abdul Kalam. Meaning, education is the most powerful weapon. The education is the key to eliminate all the problems. If you want to grow and be successful, then you need to be educated. Education is the tool which provides the people with knowledge, skills, techniques, information, and enables them to know their rights. Okay, students?
Yes.
Now, see a so beautiful picture you can see. Yes? What you can see in this picture now?
This is a scenery.
Very good.
This is a biosphere.
Very nice. Very good, children. What can you see in the sky?
Seven rainbows, mountains.
Yes.
And sun.
Very good. Mountains, birds, rainbow, sun. Very good, children. Yes. What do you see near the river bank?
Boat. House,
yes. Houses. Very good, children. Yes, house,
boat,
houses, boat.
Glass.
Yes, very good. Near the bank. Very nice, students. What is flowing through the mountain? What is flowing through the mountains here, children?
River.
Very nice. Very good. The river is flowing through the mountain.
River.
Very good, children. Yes, river. What is the color of sky? What is the color of the sky?
Blue.
Okay, very good, children. Very nice. Okay, now we will see the next slide. Okay, name the four directions.
East, west, north.
Yes, very
north,
good.
East, west, north, and south.
Very good, children.
South.
Name the sub directions which lies between the north and east.
Northeast.
Yes, north. Very good. The sub-directions are north and east. Yes, northeast lies between the north and east. Very good. Name the sub-directions which lies between the south and west.
Southeast.
Southeast.
Very good. Very good, children. Very nice answers. Now see a beautiful picture you can see here.
Yes.
Direction the sun rises.
The sun rises.
The sun rises in the east.
Very good. Very nice. Excellent. In which direction the sun sets?
The sun sets in west.
Okay. Very good. Very good, student. The sun sets in the
west.
Very nice answer. Very good. Now we will see the next slide. Which country is representing in the map?
India.
Yes. India. Very good answer. India is representing in the map. Okay. Now tell me, students, how many states are there in India?
There are 29 states.
Very good, children. Yes, 29. There are 29 states. Very good. Very good. To which state do you belong?
Maharashtra.
Yes. Green color, Maharashtra. Yes. You belong to Maharashtra.
Yes.
Very good. Yes. Now, do you know the capital of Maharashtra?
The capital.
The
Maharashtra. The
capital.
Maharashtra is Mumbai and the second capital of Maharashtra is Nagpur.
Very good children, very nice. Now from this map, now tell me, name the biggest state in the biggest state of the country. See ya, above this one. Name the biggest state of the country.
Rajasthan.
Rajasthan, very good. Rajasthan. Very good children. Rajasthan is the biggest state of the country. Now, which is, now name the smallest state of the country.
Goa.
Yeah, see ya. You can Goa. See na? Goa, yes. Goa is the smallest state of the country. Very good children. Now, name the neighboring state of Maharashtra. See ya. Neighboring state of Maharashtra.
Neighboring
state. Yes, very good. Yeah.
Neighbor is Karnataka, Gujarat, Madhya
Pradesh.
Yes,
very good. Very good, children. Karnataka, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh. So, students, our country is rich with many rivers, mountains, hills, plateaus, and lakes. So, students, you must be familiar with some of the names. Today, we are going to learn more about the India. What you are going to learn more about the India. Yes, getting to know about the India. Okay.
Yes.
Now, see ya. The beautiful picture of the map. Okay.
Yes.
Children, look at the map of India given below. It shows the different mountains in India. Okay. Now, see ya. These are the different mountains. It shows the different mountains in India. Different mountains we can see here, Vindhya Mountains, Satpura Mountains, okay, different mountains, Chota Nagpur, these are the different mountains you can see in the map. Yes, in the map you can see the different mountains. Okay, now we are going to learn about the mountains. Now first we will see what is the mountain. A mountain is a large mass of earth and rock rising well above the other common landforms. Okay, now we are going to see the mountains. Now we are going to see and learn the different mountains. Yes, see here now. Himalaya mountain, so beautiful it is, white color mountains. Yes, no, which mountain this is you can see? Tell me the children, tell me children, which mountain you can see? Yes, Himalaya mountain. Yes, the Himalaya. Yes, the Himalaya is a mountain range in the South and East Asia, separating the plains of Indian subcontinent from the Tibetan Plateau. The range has many of the Earth's highest peaks, including of the highest mountain, Mount Everest, at the border between the Nepal and China. This is the Himalaya mountain. Now, next picture we will see Ladakh mountain. Which mountain you are going to see? Ladakh mountain. See, so beautiful scenery it is, white color. Everyone, see everyone?
Yes.
See now? Yes. What is the color of the mountain you can see in this picture? White color mountains, yes. Ladakh was a region of the Indian administered state of Jammu and Kashmir. In August 2019, the Parliament of India passed an act by which the Ladakh became a union territory on 31st October 2019. Yes. Now see here, this is the picture of Ladakh. See the map. Where the Ladakh is located, see here. In which state? Jammu and Kashmir. Okay. Yes, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh is situated. Okay. Now we will see the next mountain. Okay. Aravalli Mountain. See the greenery of the Aravalli Mountain. The Aravalli Ranges is a mountain range in northwestern India running in a southwest direction, starting near Delhi, passing through the southern Haryana and Rajasthan and ending in Gujarat. The highest peak is Guru Shikhar. Which is the highest peak here? Guru Shikhar is the highest peak. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, this is the Aravalli Ranges mountain. Now, next we will see beautiful mountain. This is Sahyadri Mountain. Everyone known as Sahyadri Mountain in Maharashtra. It is very famous. Have you heard the song? Sahyadri, yes. That Jai Jai Maharashtra Maza, Garja Maharashtra Maza. That song you have heard? In that, yes, it is mentioned as Sahyadri Cha.
Oh.
You know? No? Yes, it is mentioned in that, na? Sahyadri Cha song. Ha, yeah. This is the Sahyadri Mountain, okay?
Yes.
The western ghats are also called as the Sahyadri Mountains. And the north-south chain of the mountain, which starts near the border between the state of the Gujarat and Maharashtra, run down into Goa, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and Kerala. It ends the southern tip of India near Kanyakumari. The Sahyadri Range is the physical backbone of Maharashtra. Yes, Sahyadri, where the Sahyadri Mountains are there? It is. Tell me the students now. Sahyadri Mountains are located in Maharashtra. In which state? Maharashtra and Gujarat. Okay?
Yes.
Very good. Now, next we will see which mountain we are going to see. Children, read.
Satpura.
Yes, very good. Satpura Mountain. Yes, Satpura Range is the horse mountain. The Satpura Range is the range of the hills in the central India. The range rises in the eastern Gujarat state. The highest point of the Satpura Range is Dubgarh and is located in Pachmari. Okay, it is located in Pachmari.
Pachmari.
Yes, now again we will see the new mountain. Yes, which mountain is this? Children, read. Nilgiri Mountain. Okay, beautiful picture. Nilgiri Mountain. Yes, very good. Nilgiri forms a part of the Western Ghats in West Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, and Kerala. The highest peak of Nilgiri Mountain is Dodabetta. Okay, the highest peak of Nilgiri Mountain is Dodabetta. Okay, this is the Nilgiri Mountain. Now we are going to see the sea. So children, now look at the map of India given below. It shows the different hills. Now we are going to learn about the hills. We are going to learn about the different hills. See, here the hills are shown. Which hills are there? Ajanta, Mahadev, Balaghat, Satmala, Maithal. These are the different hills are shown in the map. Okay. You can see. Yes. See, here different hills are there. Yes, na Ajanta, Balaghat, Mahadev Hills, Maithal Hills. Yes, these are the different hills shown in the map. Now we are going to see and learn the different hills. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
Now, see ya. Wow, so beautiful picture this is. Yes, na?
Yes, teacher.
All small mountains you are seeing. Everyone like it?
Yes.
Yes. See, now we will see the definition of hills. A hills is the landform that extends above the surrounding terrain. Hills are the mountains, but the smaller and the rounder. Okay? These are the small hills, the smaller and rounder. Yes, no? You can see in this picture? Yes. Now tell me, students, have you went to Ajanta Ellora?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Have you seen Ajanta Ellora?
Yes, teacher. It is so beautiful.
Yeah, it is very beautiful. Na? Yes, it is very nice to see that place. It is in Aurangabad. Okay, the Ajanta Hills are approximately 30 rock cut Buddhist caves monuments which date from 2nd century BC, about 480 CE in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra state of India. Where it is in Aurangabad district. It is very beautiful place. Students, in holidays, you go there, okay, to see the different caves, okay?
Yes.
Yes, it is a very beautiful place. Beautiful place, Buddhist caves. You can see the Buddhist caves, monuments, okay? So, in holidays, you go there for picnic. Now, the next slide. This is the beautiful place. See, Mahadev Hill, so high it is, okay? Yes, this is so beautiful now. Mahadev Hills, that is sand hills, located in the north part of Satpura Range in southern Madhya Pradesh state in central India. Okay, this is the Mahadev Hills. Now, we will go to the next. This is the Satmala Hills.
Satmala,
yes, is a mountain range which runs across the Nasik district, Maharashtra. They are an integral part of Sahyadri ranges within Nasik. Okay, the highest peak is Dodab Hills, in the third highest hill peak in Maharashtra and the 29th highest peak in the Western Ghats. This is which hills? Tell me, students, which hill this is? Satmala Hills. Okay. Very good, children. Now we will see the next hills. Name the hill now.
Balaghat Hills.
Very good. Very good. Very good, dear. Very good. Balaghat Hills. Now see, this is the Balaghat Hills. So beautiful picture it is. See the nature. Everywhere the greenery is there. The sky is looking beautiful.
Yes.
Balaghat Range is the mountain ranges. Okay. In Maharashtra state of India. Balaghat Range runs southeastward from the Western Ghat at Harishchandra Range to the border of Maharashtra and Karnataka state. Okay. Now we will see the next slide. This is which hills? Meikle Hills. Okay, this is the Meikle Hills. The Meikle Hills are the range of the hills in the state of Eastern Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, India. This is densely forested and thinly populated. The hills range is very rich in flora and fauna wealth. Which hill this is? Meikle Hills. Okay.
Meikle Hills.
Ah, very good students. Yes. Now we are going to learn
plateaus.
Plateaus. Okay. We are going to learn plateaus. Yes. We are going to learn about the plateaus. See here. Now, the different plateaus you can see here. Read now. Which plateau this is?
Maharashtra.
Ready? Yes. Plateau. Maharashtra plateau. Very good. Next, which plateau you can see?
Malnad plateau.
Yes, Deccan plateau, Maharashtra plateau. Very good, children. And which plateau you can see here? Chota Nagpur. Then here, Telangana. Yes, Telangana plateau. Here, which plateau you can see? Yes, Mewat plateau. Very good, children. Yes, these are the different plateaus you can see in the map. It shows the different plateaus in India. The map shows the different plateaus in India. So now we are going to learn about the different plateaus. Okay, plateaus. First, we will see what is plateau. Definition of plateau here. Okay, a plateau is a flat, elevated landform that rises sharply above the surrounding area on at least one side. Plateaus occur every continent and take up a third of the earth land. They are one of the fourth major landforms along with the mountains, plains, and hills. Okay. Now we will see the different plateaus now. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
First plateau we are going to see. So beautiful picture. Which plateau this is? Mewat plateau. Mewat plateau. Yes or no? Have you seen this plateau in any picture? Any idea? Have you seen which picture? Tell me. This plateau. In which picture you have seen this plateau?
Teacher, in my book.
Okay, very good. Mewat is a yes.
This Mewat is the part of Rajasthan state.
Yes, yes. Very good, very good. Excellent here. This part is of Rajasthan state of India. The Mewat region lies between the Aravalli ranges to the northwest, Ajmer to the north, Gujarat and the Bagad region of Rajasthan to the south, the Malwa region of the Madhya Pradesh state to the southeast, and Hadodati region of the Rajasthan to the east. Okay, this Mewat. Now we will see the next plateau, Chota Nagpur plateau. Okay, this is the Chota Nagpur plateau.
Chota
Nagpur plateau. Yes, Chota Nagpur plateau is a plateau in eastern India, which covers so much of Jharkhand state as well as adjacent part of Odisha, West Bengal and Chhattisgarh. Okay, this is the which plateau this is?
Chota Nagpur plateau.
Very good, Chota Nagpur plateau. Yes, understood about the Chota Nagpur. Now we will see the new plateau. Which plateau this is? Everyone is familiar with this word, Maharashtra. Yes. Now we are going to see about Maharashtra plateau. The Maharashtra Desh is a plateau of plateaus. Its western upturned rims rising to form the Sahyadri range, and in a slope gently descending towards the east and southeast. Okay. So beautiful scenery. It is seen here. See the sea of water, blue color, greenery everywhere.
Yes.
Like this picture, everyone?
Yes, teacher, I like.
Yes, so very good, very good. Now we will see the next plateau, Telangana plateau. Okay, which plateau we are going to now learn about? The
Telangana.
Yes. Telangana plateau. The Telangana plateau is in the West Andhra Pradesh state, southeastern India. The plateau is drained by the Godavari River, taking a southeasterly course by the Krishna River, which divides the peneplain into two regions, okay, and by the Penuru River flowing in northly direction. Okay, so beautiful picture. See the ranges, how the range of the mountains are seen here. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, now next we will see Karnataka. Okay, Karnataka Plateau. The Karnataka Plateau is upland region of Karnataka state, southern India. The name of the plateau is derived from the Kannad, that is the land of the black soil. What is this Karnataka Plateau is also called as the land of black soil. Okay.
Land of black soil.
Yes. Land of black soil. Now, we will move towards the rivers. Now, children, look at the map of the India given below. It shows the different rivers in India. Now, we are going to learn about the different rivers. Now, students, now from this map, now name some rivers now. You know.
Kaveri, Krishna.
Yes, very good. Krishna, Kaveri.
Yamuna, Ganga, Godavari.
Yeah, very good. Very good. Ganga, Narmada, Yamuna.
Teacher, the longest river in our world is Nile.
Yes, very good. Excellent answer you're giving. Very nice. Yes. Now see here above. Now which rivers you can see here? Satluj River, Ravi, Indus. Yeah, different rivers are seen.
Yes.
See here. Very good. Now here. Mahanadi. Yes. Now these different rivers are. These different rivers we are going to see now. Okay. Yes. Now see here. So the beautiful rivers now we can see here. Now first we will see the what is river. Okay. And these rivers which originate in the Himalayas. These rivers are originate in Himalayas. These above rivers are there. These rivers originate in the Himalayas. Now first we will see the what is river. Okay. River is the stream of water that flows across the land. Okay. Yes, very good. Now next. Now we are going to learn about which river? Jhelum River. Which river?
Jhelum
River. Yes.
Jhelum River.
Jhelum River is a river that flows from the Indian administered territory of Jammu and Kashmir. It is the westernmost of the five rivers of the Punjab region and passes through the Kashmir Valley. Okay, this is the Jhelum River. From where it passes? It passes through the Punjab. It passes from where? It is the westernmost of the five rivers of the Punjab region and passes through the Kashmir Valley. Okay, so beautiful picture you can see. Yes, so different rivers are there. Yes, the nature is very beautiful. How is the nature? See here. Everywhere greenery is very beautiful. Yes, and the nature's beauty. Yes. Now, next, we are going to see the Ravi River. Okay, see the river, how it is flowing. Very nice, na? Water, see how the water is flowing here.
Yes, teacher.
Yes. The Ravi River is a transboundary river crossing the northwestern India. Okay, and the eastern Pakistan. It is the one of the six rivers of the Indus system in Punjab region. The Ravi River originates in the Himalayas in the Multan Tehsil of. Okay. And the Kangra district of Himachal Pradesh, India. Okay. The Ravi River is the biggest river. See, it is the one of the six rivers of Indus system in Punjab. Okay. Now we will see the another river. Which river this is? Name the river.
Satluj River.
That is, which river this is? Satluj River. Okay.
Satluj River.
This is Satluj River. Yes. The Satluj River is the longest of the five rivers that flows through the historic crossroads region of Punjab in northern India and Pakistan. The Satluj River is also known as the Satadri. Okay. So Bakra Dam is built around the river Satluj. Which dam is built around the Satluj River?
Bakra Dam is built.
Yes. Bakra Dam is built around the Satluj River. Okay. Now we will see that again. Now we are going to see the main rivers flowing in the South India. Children, look at the map of the India given below. It shows the different rivers flowing in the southern India. Now we will see the again different rivers. Which rivers we are going to see here? Same here. Now we are going to learn about the Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari. These are the main rivers we are going to learn about. Okay. Kaveri, Krishna and Godavari. Yes, these rivers we are going to now learn. Okay. Now we will see the next river. Okay. That is Kaveri. Kaveri River. Everyone is well known this word, na? Kaveri River. Have you heard this word, na? Yes, Kaveri, Godavari, Krishna. These are the famous rivers. Okay.
Teacher,
and biggest rivers. Yes.
Kaveri flow through the state of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu.
Yes, very good. Excellent. Kaveri is an Indian river flowing through the state of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. It is the third largest river after Godavari and Krishna in South India and the largest in the state of Tamil Nadu. Okay. This is the Kaveri River and it is the third largest river after Godavari and Krishna. Okay. Now we will see the next river. So beautiful. This word is familiar now.
Krishna River.
Yes, this river is familiar to you now. Krishna River. The yes. Krishna River is the fourth biggest river in the term of water inflows and river basin area in India. After the Ganga and Godavari and Brahmaputra, the river, it is also called as the Krishna Veni. Okay, this river is also called as Krishna Veni. Yes, this is the fourth biggest river. Okay. Now we will see the next river. This is also Godavari. The big river. Yes, Godavari River. Have you heard this word Godavari, na?
Yes,
yes. This is the Godavari River. The Godavari River rises from the Trambakeshwar in Nashik district of Maharashtra. The Godavari is India's second largest river after the Ganga. Which is the second largest river after the Ganga?
Godavari.
Yes, the Godavari is the second largest river after the Ganga. Okay. Ganga, so beautiful color of the, what is the color of the river? See, what is the color of the water you can see in this picture?
Dark blue.
Yes, very good. So beautiful, na, it is blue color water.
Yes, teacher.
Very good. Yes, you like it?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, very good. Now we'll see the next. Now we are going to study about the lakes. Okay. Look at the map of the India given below. It shows about the different lakes. Okay. Now see here. Now what you can see in this map? Read it. Can you read this? Can you read this? Which lake this is?
Sambhar Lake.
Very good. This is Sambhar Lake. Very good. This is Sambhar Lake, Pulkit Lake, Kolleru Lake, Chilika Lake. These are the different lakes now we are going to see and we are going to learn. Okay. Now first we will see the definition. What is lake? Okay. A lake is a large body of water, larger and deeper than a pond, within a body of land. As a lake is separated from the oceans, it is not a sea. Lake, see here. Lakes do not flow like rivers, but many have rivers flowing into and out of them. Okay. Now we are going to see the different rivers. Okay. Now, see the next one. Okay. Now what you are going to see the different lakes. Not the first lake. Now this is Vullar Lake. Which lake?
Vullar Lake.
Yes. Now Vullar Lake is one of the largest freshwater lakes in Asia. It is situated in Bandipura district in Jammu and Kashmir, India. Okay. So beautiful picture there. See, this is the picture. How beautiful scenery it is there. Yes.
Largest fresh water in Asia.
Yes, largest fresh water lake in Asia. Okay, this is the largest fresh water lake in Asia. Okay, very good. And where it is situated? It is in district of Jammu and Kashmir in India. Okay, see the picture. Everyone like this picture? Green, yes. Green water, green, blue colors and white color sky. See how beautiful scenery it is.
Teacher, yes, no? There is so too. So beautiful picture.
Oh, yes. Okay, very good. Now we will see the next lake. Which lake we are going to see now?
Sambhar Lake.
Yes, Sambhar Lake. This is the lake, Sambhar Salt Lake. India's largest inland salt lake is located in southwest of city of Jaipur and northeast of Ajmer and Rajasthan. Okay, this is also a largest inland salt lake. Where it is located? It is located in southwest of
Ajmer, Rajasthan.
Yes, very good. Ajmer, Rajasthan. Okay, this is the Sambhar lake. Now we will go to the next slide. We will see the next lake. Okay.
Lohar lake. Lonar Lake.
Yes. Lonar Lake. Okay. Now we are going to learn about the Lonar Lake. Yes. Lonar Lake is also known as the Lonar Crater. It's notified the National Geoheritage Monuments Saline Soda Lake located at Lonar in Buldhana district, Maharashtra, India. See the Lonar Lake, how it is? Circle. Round. See. What is the shape of that lake? See here. Go. Yes, round lake it is, Lonar Lake. Okay, this Lonar Lake is a, which lake it is situated? It is situated in Buldhana district, Maharashtra. Yes. Buldhana district, it is in Buldhana district, Maharashtra.
And India.
Yes, very good. Now we will see the next lake. Which lake it is now we are going to see? This is
Kolleru
the
Lake.
Kolleru Lake. Very good. This is the Kolleru Lake. Okay. Now, see the beautiful picture, how it is. Yes, the Kolleru Lake is one of the largest freshwater lakes in India. Okay. Located in the state of Andhra Pradesh and forms the largest shallow freshwater lake in Asia. Yes. Which lake this is now? Tell me which is the largest lake. Yes, Kolleru Lake. Yes, Kolleru Lake is one of the largest lake, freshwater lake in India. And it is located where? In which state?
Asia.
Andhra Pradesh. Yes, in the state of Andhra Pradesh. And form the largest shallow freshwater lake in Asia. Okay, very good. Now, we have learned till now about what we have learned about mountains, rivers, plateaus, hills and lakes. Yes. Well, yes, no? Now we are going to learn about the different productions. Okay. Now which picture is this?
Saffron. Flowers. Yes.
Have you seen saffron? Have you seen saffron?
Yes.
Yes. Kishore, have you seen that?
Yes.
Yes. Saffron you are using now? For drinking milk. Yes. While drinking milk, you are putting the saffron. Yes, now?
Yes.
Yes. What is the color of saffron?
Purple red or purple.
Okay. The saffron is a legendary crop of Jammu and Kashmir, where the ideal climate conditions are available. What?
Miss, this flower is only grow in Jammu and Kashmir.
Jammu and Kashmir. Yes. Very good. Excellent. Yes. This flower is only grown in Jammu and Kashmir. Yes. This flower is available where? It is not here grown. Yes, very good. Yes, yes.
Located in the Jammu and Kashmir.
Yes, this flower is only found in Jammu and Kashmir, not in other states. Okay, very good students. The saffron, then this saffron is very good. You know, now you all are using, we have to use, this saffron is used for drinking. When you are using milk, when you are drinking milk, you have to put the saffron here and you have to drink the milk. Okay. This is very good for your health also. Yes. 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 And now the saffron is the legendary crop of Jammu and Kashmir. Yes. And this is available good growth and flower production. Jammu and Kashmir is only the state in India where the saffron is produced. Means what? Jammu and Kashmir is the only one state where the saffron is produced. Okay. Now we will see the next slide. What is this picture now? Tell me.
Orange.
Name the fruit. Orange. Yes. Everyone like to eat orange?
Yes.
Yes. Everyone like to. Yes. Very good. Yes. You like. Yes.
Maharashtra, Karnataka.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
And Rajasthan. Yes. Karnataka, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan.
Very good. Very good, students. And orange production. Nasi. Yes, yes, yes.
Nasi
orange. Yes. Orange production. Is yes. Where it is it? Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Punjab, Haryana, and Rajasthan. The area producing this are Vidarbha, Darjeeling, Meghalaya, Assam, Nagpur, Akola, and Punjab. In these states, what happened? In these states, this fruit is grown. Where the production is there, Maharashtra is the leading orange producing state. Okay, everyone like to eat oranges?
Yes.
Yes. You like the juice, orange juice, everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, very good. It is very tasty and healthy for you, okay? You have to drink orange juice also for vitamin. Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
Now we will see the next one. Okay. Wow, so beautiful this is. Everyone
mango.
Mangoes, yes. Everyone like to eat mangoes. Mango is the favorite fruit. Yes, na? Everyone like?
Yes.
Which is your favorite fruit now? Tell me, everyone. Like this
teacher,
mango, orange, so much
like
yes.
Mangoes.
Yes, teacher. You like mangoes. Okay, and mango juice.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, you like. Okay, mango juice, and you like the pickle also. Mango pickle.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. This is the. Okay. Okay. Very good.
I like something, but I like mango too much.
Huh. Okay. Okay. Now see here. We will see about the mango. Mango is the national fruit of India. Worldwide, there are several hundred cultivars of mangoes. Yes, dear?
Mango is the king of fruit.
Yes, mango is the king of fruit. Yes, mango is the king of fruit. Depending on the cultivator, mango fruit is various in size, shape, sweetness, skin, color, and flesh color, which may be pale yellow, gold, or oranges. Yes, you can see the mangoes different colors, na?
Yes, teacher.
Which color mango color you have seen? Tell me.
Green.
Yellow
also. Gold. And yes, gold. And which color?
Gold. Orange, yellow.
Okay.
And green. And also green.
Yes, yes. In green color also. Mango comes in green color also. Yellow color also. Pale yellow color. Gold. Okay. Now we will see the next one. Apples. Very good. Everyone like to eat apples?
Yes, yes, miss.
Yes. Now see the beautiful apples here now. Okay. What is the color of the apple?
Red.
Yes, red color. Okay.
Teacher, Jammu and Kashmir is known to be the den of the
apple production.
Yes, very good. Jammu and an apple is an edible fruit. Jammu and Kashmir is known to be a den of apple production.
And we can make the apples juices, jellies.
Yes, apples are mostly consumed fresh, but a small part of the production is processed into the juice, jellies, canned, slices, and other items. You have seen chocolates also, apple chocolates also there. Candy, yes. Apple candies, apple ice cream. No?
Apple is the 11th most popular peach brand and the most famous.
Okay, very good. The apple are. So everyone like to eat apple. You have to eat apple daily, okay?
Yes.
Regularly you have to eat apple. Apple is the best for your health, okay? In morning you have to eat apple. Yes? It is the best for your health. So while taking breakfast, you have to eat apple. Okay. Now next, we are going to see the tea. Everyone like to drink tea? Yes?
No, teacher.
No? No one likes? Okay. But tea is very famous, na? Yes.
Teacher, I like coffee to drink.
Okay, okay. We will see the coffee also next. Yes. India is the one of the largest tea producer in the world. Although over 70% of it, tea is consumed within India itself. A number of renowned teas such as Assam and
Darjeeling.
Yes.
Darjeeling,
India. Yes, Assam and Darjeeling. Yes, these are the famous states that each grows the tea. Which state is the largest tea producer in India? Assam. Yes, Assam and Darjeeling. Yes, these are the largest states which produce tea in India. Yes, in morning when you get up early in the morning, first what you know, first what you take? Tea to drink. Yes.
Yes. I take the milk.
Yes, but what you have to do in morning when you get up, what you have to take? You have to take milk, no tea and coffee. You have to drink milk, okay? And
yes, then you can daily drink milk.
Yes, you have to daily. Yes, very good, very good. Okay, very nice, students. Now, next we are going to see coffee.
Yes, yes. Just now you told us coffee is favorite. Yes, yes, mine also. Yeah, coffee. Where the coffee was not seen in this map, it is shown. India is the third largest producer and exporter of the coffee in Asia, and the sixth largest producer and the fifth largest exporter of the coffee in the world. Everyone like to drink coffee?
Yes,
I too like to drink coffee. Yes, coffee is my favorite. Okay.
My also coffee is favorite.
Yes, you also like to drink coffee. Okay, very good, very good. Yes, but you should not drink coffee and tea. What you should drink?
Milk.
Yes, you should drink milk. Okay.
Yes.
And yes, very good, students. Now we are going to see about the coffee. Now you tell me the who will say where the coffee grow? In which state the coffee grow?
Coffee grow in Asia.
Okay, Asia. Very good. Yes. And it is the largest producer. Yes, largest producer.
And the fifth largest exporter of coffee.
And the fifth largest.
Okay, very good. Very good. Now, next we are going to see. Okay, just now we have seen. What we have seen now? We have studied about the, with the help of the map, we learned about the mountains, hills, plateaus, rivers, lakes, and different production, that is saffron, apples, mangoes, tea, and coffee. Now, what we have to do, just see here. What you will do now, children, look at the map of India given below. Okay. From this map, you have to find out the answers. You have to search the answers. Okay. So children, look at the map of India given below. And it shows the different hills, mountains, rivers, plateaus, lakes. Okay. So you have to answer the question. Yes. Now first we will do beta. Now, what you have to do?
Finding mountain.
You have to find down. Yes. Now first we will evaluation now. Find the mountain. Yes. Find the mountain and name them. Now you have to, what you have to do? Just 1 minute. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, 1 minute. Now you have to find the mountain. See here. See in this map where the mountains are there. Just now we learn about the different mountains, no? Yes. Which mountains are there? See here. Yes, Himalaya mountains. About Himalaya mountains are there. Then next, which mountain you can see? See which mountains you can see here?
Akatlianga.
Okay. See Aravali mountains here. Down here now. Sahyadri mountain ranges. Vidya mountain. Vindhya mountains here. Okay. So different mountains you can see here now. Yes. Okay. Yes. Satpura mountain. See here. It is here only. Near only. Satpura mountain. Yes. Now the next question. Name the hills shown on the map. Now you are going to see the hills. Name some hills from the map. Yes, yes, very good. Ajanta Hill. See, it is about. See the hills. Name the hills now. From the map. Yes. Yes, Balaghat. Very good answer. Excellent. Balaghat Hill. Very good. Here now down. See here. Now which hill you can see here?
Satmala Hills.
Very good. Satmala Hills. Now here again. Above here. See here. Michael Hills, very good answer. Michael Hills.
Ajanta Hills.
Yes, very good answer. See, it is shown here. Ajanta Hills. You can see now? Ajanta Hills.
Yes.
Very good. Okay. Now, next one. Find the plateaus in the map and name them. Now, you have to search the plateaus from this. Yes.
Miss Deshian Plateau.
Very good. Deccan Plateau. Very. Yes. Very good. Now next. And now which? Another plateau. Deccan Plateau. Now next plateau. See ya. You can see now?
Yes.
Yes. Mewat Plateau. See ya above here. Mewat Plateau. Yes. And here down. We will go again down. Here. Which plateau it is? Karnataka Plateau. You can see ya. Down Karnataka Plateau. Okay. And here now. Which plateau you can see? Maharashtra Plateau. Here. Okay. These are the different
plateau.
Yes, Telangana Plateau. Very good answer. Very good, children. Very good. Very nice. Okay. Now, Name the lake shown on the map. Now you are going to find out the lake shown on the map. Yes, you have to find out the lake shown on the map. Okay, find out the lake now. Okay.
Miss Gandhara.
Lake you can see. Yes. Lake. Ganga is the river, dear. Ganga is the river. We are going to see now lake. Bullar Lake. Hear about this here. Bullar Lake. Hear down. We learn about Sambhar Lake. Yes, na? Yes. Sambhar Lake. Ah, yes. Now next year down, we will see the Lonar Lake. Okay. You can see na lake. See at Tilka Lake. See it is here. Lonar Lake. Okay. Now here you can see. Okay. See here now. From here. See which lake you can see?
Til.
Touch it. Okay, very good. Now you can see the Bullar Lake, here Sambhar Lake, Lonar Lake and Polirur Lake. Okay, these are the different lakes you can see in the map. See here the lake is there, Chilika Lake. Okay, now?
Yes,
very good. Now we will see the next question. Now it is the question, see here. Name any three rivers shown on the map. Yes.
Ganga.
Yes. Very good. Which river you can see? Yes. Which river? Ganga River. Yes.
Kaveri. Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari.
Godavari. Yes, Krishna also. See, it is that. You can see the Krishna River. Yes. Godavari, Kaveri, Krishna. Yes.
The lake name.
Yes, Satluj Lake, Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari. Yes. Sambhar Lake it is. Yeah. That is lake. We are learning about now. Which question we are learning?
River.
Name any three rivers. Yeah. Yes. I'm asking about the rivers. Lakes over now. The question. Just now we have learned about the lakes. Now my question is now name three rivers. Okay.
Ganga.
Just now you have. Yes. Ganga. Again yeah. Next river. Which river you can see? Godavari, Krishna, here Ravi. Here it is above. Ah, yes, it is seen above. See here. See here. Above. It is there. Okay. Jhelum River, Satluj River. Here Satluj River. Satluj and above which river is there? Ravi. Above here. See. These are the different rivers. Okay. Very good. Very good, students. Now we will see the next question. Match the following. Okay. Your next question you are going to see. Match the following. A column and B column. Yes. Orange. Yes. Yes. Very good. Orange. Yes. Grown in which state? Nagpur. Yes. Very good.
Jammu Kashmir.
Yes. Yes. Very good. T. Assam. Yes.
Apples.
And apple. Apple grown in which state? Yeah.
Jammu and Kashmir.
Apple goes in with state. Jammu and Kashmir. Very good, children. Yes, very good, children. Okay. Now, next, we will see the next slide. This is the homework. Okay. In which state saffron is grown? Jammu and Kashmir. Very good. Which state is famous for the production of mangoes? Yes. This is the question. Yes. Maharashtra state. Okay. Which mountains are located in? Yes. Which mountains are located in Maharashtra? Just now we learn about the different mountains that you have to write. Okay. And the last question is, name the rivers which originate in the Himalaya. Just now I told about the rivers, na? River Satluj, Kaveri, Krishna, Ravi, Jhelum. These are the rivers which originate in the Himalayas. Okay. This question answers you have to write.
Okay,
teacher. Yes, very good. Now, just now we have learned about different rivers, lakes. Yes, now? Mountains,
yes.
Rivers, lakes, hills, plateaus. Yes, okay. So, we studied about the India with the help of map. We learned what? We learned about the mountains, hills, plateaus, rivers, lakes, and different production. Okay,
teacher, I understand.
Yes, very good. Now, I hope children, you all are safe and fine. Stay healthy and stay blessed. Don't go out. Use sanitizers and wear masks. Okay, dear children?
Yes, teacher.
God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.